My name is Roy Jennings. I'm a senior here at the university. My major is sport business. My minor is business administration. And today I'm going to be talking about, is hosting the Olympics beneficial to a city? So former boxer Floyd Mayweather Jr. once said, "I'm going to always bleed the red, white, and blue. I represent the U.S. in the Olympics, and I love my country. But the U.S. fans will love you on Monday. If you lose, they'll hate you on Tuesday. If you win, it will be back to loving you on Wednesday." And this quote represents the culture of sports in most countries, but more specifically, the emotions that result in the Olympic Games. What if someone were to ask the question, what if they disbanded the Olympics? How would people react? For many people, the Olympics is an award for an athlete's astonishing work, a tourist attraction, and entertainment. But not too many people know that there can be many negative consequences for hosting the Games in their country. This presentation is going to explore the positive and negatives of hosting the Games, which is going to answer the question, is hosting the Olympics beneficial? So as I just said, I'm going to talk about the positive and negatives of hosting the Olympic Games, but also a brief history of the Olympics and why the Olympics actually take place. And then at the end, I'm going to give my personal opinion of hosting Olympics in a city. So let's go back in time. Looking at the official website of the Olympics, the beginning of these world events can be traced back to as early as 7076 BC in ancient Olympia. Paul Christine, a professor of ancient Greek history at Dartmouth College, mentions that it is hard for individuals to visualize how important the Olympic Games were to the Greeks. Events such as chariot racing, boxing, and wrestling were the sporting and social cultural highlights of ancient Greek calendar, and it's fair to say that these events play the same role in modern-day societies. So the Organization on World Peace says, the Olympics were created to unify countries into one tournament. It brings together many nationalities over one match, and it's where athletes are expected to respect the strict regulations and compete fairly. Furthermore, the Olympics encourages diversity and multiculturalism, which is one positive effect of hosting the Games, says an online article that was published in 2016 by Jishu Shin. So to go in depth about the positives of hosting Olympic Games, one example of a country that did benefit from holding the events is the 2000 Olympic Games that was held in Sydney, Australia. The Olympics says the city worked hard to minimize the environmental impact of hosting the events. The venue that were built for the Games were made using sustainable materials and designed with a strong focus of energy and water conservation. Also, hosting these Games led to the country's first water recycling system, which is still used today, which they're saving water every year. One common mistake for countries is hosting Olympics is building infrastructures for the events, and then they're abandoned afterwards. So, I mean, they build all these buildings and infrastructures for the Olympics, and then they're not used. But Sydney, Australia did a good example of what a country should do and used it afterwards. So freelance writer Paul Goodman in an online article says that tourism is a key source of income and employment in modern day society. It brings new money to the economy for a country and can make up a significant proportion of the national income. In addition to, it provides jobs for many locals. Looking at the Olympic perspective, many countries have to build infrastructures such as hotels, restaurants, and even transports, which all require staffing. Lastly, it gives a place a chance to show itself off and raise its profile in a large world we live in today. The Olympics also are a major showpiece and have to become the most celebrated event in history. That being said, one positive of the events is the overall entertainment it brings to across the globe. Pound says that the world events may shape society in ways that people cannot anticipate, meaning that if the Olympics did not occur, many athletes would not have a reason to compete, and it would just reduce the way countries come together and share a common goal. With this, the Olympics and sport as a whole provide value for you. Evidence of ethical failures is all around us in business, in politics, and science, in education, and education, and in religion. There is moral decay in sports as well, as a subset in the same society. This quote from the book Pound shows how sports play a role for the youth to help them learn a full range of society or social activity that provides a value tool for how the world operates. That being said, some believe that the Olympics are, if the Olympics are eliminated, from the world of sports. It may give some sports or people no additional value other than just playing for personal entertainment with no actual competition. So with all this together, the Olympics brings people with different cultures together. Revenue and tourism, personal entertainment, and if done correctly, a place of attraction after the Olympics events have come to rest. That being said, there are consequences of hosting the Olympics. I'm going to talk about the bid process, which is the beginning of how the Olympics takes place in each city. I'm going to talk about the impact it has on the economy, like I mentioned earlier, the infrastructures, tourism as well, and then the local citizens. So according to an online article by Smith College professor Andrew Zimbalist, the problem starts with the bid process, which is where the countries apply to host the Olympics in one of their major cities. This is an event itself where the country proves that they are capable of performing the events effectively and safely. Unfortunately, it's very difficult to tell if the country will actually benefit from hosting, but countries are willing to place a large bid so the entire world can see the country and show it off. The more money that's spent on the bid, the less money is able to be made and used to build infrastructures and things needed to successfully host the Olympics, resulting in a loss. So Zimbalist says, in a perfect world, urban planners would sit down and deliberately map out the use of scarce urban real estate based on the infrastructure, operational, and sustainability needs of the city. However, this is not the case. Most countries do not know what it takes to host such a large sporting event. To get a better understanding of these consequences, there are many examples that can be reflected on the show of how countries have suffered from hosting Olympics. The examples I've shown in this presentation are just a few. Many countries have affected negatively economically